I'm Titus Nelson with Cat 6 Tools. I'm here with my friend Bill Healy, and we're digging four holes for concrete to put under this metal frame. We're using our new hydrovac and our tilt drum, which is 30 gallons, and we have a 10-gallon vacuum. This vacuum pulls 140 inches of water suction and easily pulls the water from our hydrovac jets that are digging into the ground, sucks slurry all the way up into our drum through this hose. This hose here is for our vacuum, and we have a filter underneath this lid with a float. So if we get too much water in here, the float automatically shuts off and we're able to dump it into 5-gallon buckets, Honda engine driven hydrovac, and we have a foot pedal here and we push the foot pedal and that causes the water then to go down through the three jets in the digger. So Bill, what do you think of using this hydrovac for digging your hole over here?
I've dug quite a few big holes in different various parts of the yard for trees and habitat stuff for turtles, but if you're trying to dig a precise hole, 6, 8, 12 inches, you can't just go at it with a pickaxe or with a post hole digger or something. This caliche is too tough. You'll be out there hours trying to dig a precise hole and never get it done. We dug several holes in various parts of my yard, and all of them, 15, 20 minutes. I just don't see an easier way to do it.
You've used the dry post hole digger, the vacuum assisted digger, as compared to the hydrovac. How do you like the difference?
The hydrovac will cut that caliche, it'll cut through most of it. Sometimes you still got to get a breaker bar, but most of the time it'll just cut through it. And then you're just sawing it. The hydro is just really the way to go.
What did you do with the water?
Well, I put it on my plants, so don't want to, Vegas, you got to save water. So been a drought everywhere for a long time. So we just repurpose it on our plants.
How much water did it take to dig a hole?
About 20 gallons.
And you used two different power washers. One was a 14 horse?
13.
13, and one was a 5 horse.
Yeah.
Did you see any difference?
Well, the 13 horse has got more power as far as blasting the water out of your hydrojet when you're digging. We used about the same amount of water. Might have been a little more water for a 13 horse, but mainly you got more horsepower. So you're probably running a little more water through it.
So you got higher pressure, which helps break the dirt up better. How do you like that new vacuum?
That's a cat's meow. the vacuum is still dry, even though that huge drum behind us had about 20 gallons of water in it, but your vacuum is still dry. So we're not getting any bleed over into the vacuum from the water. So that's pretty cool.
Was that drum easy to use to dump the water out?
Yeah, you just tilt it and pour it out. Even so, you can tip it and just pour it into a big trough or whatever. It rolls easy. You know, you can move it to wherever you want to pour it, so you don't have to be stuck where the drum is. It's portable.
Now, it takes a little more time to set up for digging.
Yeah.
You've got vacuum hoses and drums, and you got a hydrovac. How difficult was the setup as compared to if you had to go dig the hole?
Well, you know, everything has a procedure to it. So it's just a matter of pulling out your equipment and getting with the program. So it's pretty simple operation. So it's just country boy friendly. At any rate, how long it takes you to set up, you can dig that hole in 15 or 20 minutes, 2 feet deep, and tough caliche. You're not going to do that with the hand tools and have any resemblance of a certain size hole that you're trying to accomplish.
This is our hole dug with a Holey-Moley Hydro Digger. 28 inches deep.